Hey guys, welcome back to my channel, and today I'm going to do a tutorial on this look that you are seeing right now using the products that I want to use up in 2016. I was tagged by the lovely Olivia, or Liv, from Livloveshermakeup. They are doing a collaboration with a few other ladies here on YouTube, which was the brainchild of Elle from Elle for Living. So I'm going to link down below all of the ladies who are doing this collaboration, just so you can see them and watch them. And yeah, so I am going to be using the products that I want to use for 2016 in this tutorial. So if you want to see what those products are and how I'm going to use them, then please keep on watching. Okay, so I'm going to start off with my Chanel Perfection Lumiere foundation in beige 40. And I'm going to be using that with my Real Techniques, what is this called? Miracle Complexion sponge. Now, the only thing I have on my face right now is the Max Strobe Cream as sort of my primer and highlighting kind of medium. So I'm putting that all over my face. Now I'm going to powder that with MAC Mineralized Skin Finish Natural in medium deep, just to make it a little bit closer to my skin tone. Okay, am I the only one who said that Professor Snape or Alan Rickman in real life has passed away? I hope I'm not. That really saddened me, that news, especially since they announced another Harry Potter book. And then, it's not going to be the same without Professor Snape, would it? Now I'm going to spray that with my Urban Decay All Nighter Makeup Setting Spray. So that it's not too powdery after I've put on that layer of powder from the MAC Mineralized Skin Finish. Okay, now I'm going to go ahead and get my eye primer, which is the NARS Pro Prime Smudge Proof Eyeshadow Base. And you only need a little bit of this to get the priming that you want. And it already is going to work all over your lids. Now I'm going to use my Lorac Mega Pro palette. I'm sorry, you guys. I know that this was limited edition and a lot of people were upset that they didn't get to have it. But I really want to hit pan on at least 4 of these eyeshadows to make it worth my money. And my favorite here is either Sepia or Camel. Camel is more like my all over lid shade. It's a very yellowish brown. And I love it. I believe Bobbi Brown has something very similar to it, but that's a lot more expensive for a single shadow. Although it does have a lot more product in it. My only complaint about this Lorac shadows, they're very powdery and they kick up a lot of dust. So if that's not something that you like, you might not like this. I'm going to go in with cream, which is my favorite highlight, brow bone highlight. Then I'm going to go in with a crease brush, and I'm going to go in with espresso. Doesn't matter if it looks really weird right now. I'm going to blend that in. I'm gonna get that same brush that I used to put on the camel color, which is a very fluffy brush, and I'm gonna blend in that espresso color. Once that's done, I'm gonna get a flat brush, and I'm gonna get that that maroon shade right here, which I've never touched before. Now is the first time I'm doing that. I'm gonna put that all over the lid because it's pretty. Now, when I use a powdery shadow on my eyelids, I make sure that I conceal last so that I can at least clean up whatever fallout that created. I'm using my Collection Lasting Perfection concealer. I'm just putting that underneath there. I'm gonna use the tip of my complexion brush. And bring that down and in. I'm gonna put a little bit of that concealer on my forehead, like so, a little bit on the bridge of the nose. I'm gonna keep this bow, and on my chin. Now, for bronzer, I'm going to go in with my Hoola bronzer. Okay, this also needs to be done soon. I'm just going to do it like that, sort of to amplify this area here. Okay, I'm also going to use that. It's a little bit of a contour shade. Or a shading shade, what? Down here. Because I'm not a fair person, so using a gray or a taupey color on me just looks a little bit awkward. Got a very yellow undertoned skin there. Okay, now to bring in blush, I'm going to use the Stila convertible color in Peony. I've had this for a while. It needs to get done, and I'm going to be using once again my trusty old complexion sponge, and I'm just going to apply that on the apples of the cheeks like so. There's a little hair that's stuck to it. There you go. Don't you just find that annoying? When you're trying to do your makeup and a lash would fall. I find that cream blushes look more natural. There you go. And then highlight. I want a white highlight. See if my face wasn't light enough. Actually, I'll do that with this again. There you go. And a little bit of that on the tip of my nose because why not? There you go. Well, we're not done with the eyes, so I don't know why I went straight to the rest of the face, but I'm going to go ahead and take a black eyeliner. This is from Tarte, and it's an Onyx. I'm going to go ahead and tight line. When your eyeliners are getting hard or getting dry, sharpen them. Because usually that works. I mean, at least for me it does. Gonna put a little bit on the waterline as well. I'm gonna take a small smudge brush. I'm gonna go ahead and smudge that in. Then I'm gonna put on mascara, and that's gonna be my Maybelline Lash Sensational. And then some false lashes, and then I'm gonna come back to you guys. Alright, so I've stacked together a wispy and a demi wispy from Kara Lashes, and that's what you're seeing on my eyes at the moment. Now I'm gonna do my eyebrows, and I'm gonna use my Tarte Emphasize Waterproof Amazonian Clay. And this is still quite full. I don't know what I'm gonna do with the arrow. But I feel like it's not as dark as it used to be. This is supposed to be rich brown, but it looks taupe to me now. So I'm just gonna go ahead and line and follow and fill in my brows like so. I'm then gonna go and bring in a spoolie to make that look a little bit less pronounced. And then I'm gonna go in with my MAC Brow Set and Beguile to sort of lighten a little bit that first part. Where I also have, what do you call this? Longer brows. Because Beguile has got a little bit of a light tint, sort of a golden tint actually. So there you go. I'm gonna do the other side now. So for lips, I'm gonna go ahead and use Illicit. This is one of those Urban Decay minis. And I'm gonna put that all over my lips. That's what that looks like. I always thought it was going to be a little bit more, what do you call that? Pigmented, but it's not. I remember it being more pigmented. Maybe it's gone bad. And I continue to put it on my lips, yes. There you go. I was going to put on lip gloss, but I don't think I need it right now because this is really shiny and sparkly at the moment. Let me go ahead and layer that on. Still very creamy though. I like that color. I didn't think I would like it on me because it looked really blue-toned pink, but yeah, kind of went well with what's on my eyes. So that's the look for you guys. So I'm going to go ahead and release my hair since it's, I've had it in a braid since last night. I put on the Living Proof Style Extender and we will see if this will really help with the style. Come on, let go. Maybe I'll sit a little farther so you can see that that turned the bottom of my hair a little bit curly. Just gonna brush my hand through it. More sort of beachy and I look like nothing. Anyway, thank you very much for watching. I hope you like this tutorial. If you did, please do give me a thumbs up and comment down below if you have any questions or comments or violent reactions. And oh, lastly, subscribe if you haven't already. Bye.